We have with us John Flansbury, John Linnell, and is it Marty on drums today?
Marty Beller.
Marty Beller on drums. They Might Be Giants are back in the studio. Couldn't be happier. Lovely to have you back in the UK, fellas. Welcome.
We are Thanks super psyched to be here.
Marty, you weren't named after the Ernest Borgnine movie, do you think? Where there was a kind of disadvantaged fellow?
I was named after me.
Okay, because that was a great movie, and you don't see those kind of things on TV enough anymore.
Oscar loves the mentally challenged.
Well, apart from when they're played by Sean Penn, of course. Did you see that one, I Am Sam?
No.
Oh, that was a car crash.
Somebody said that he's retiring from movies.
Well, we can
because
hope.
Of that movie.
Because of like a long string of people complaining that his movies are bad.
His movies have become somewhat bad, and his performances become somewhat, shall we call it, larger than life, to be polite. But good luck to him, wherever he may be. I know he's a regular listener to the
Thank
show.
You, Sean.
How nice to have They Might Be Giants. It means summer's almost upon us if They Might Be Giants are back in town.
You're We're not in the playing bitch pit with well, They Might Be Giants.
You're not playing that many gigs at this time. You used to be coming over. I don't know whether you're slowing down or whether you're just getting tired.
We did a London, a whole UK tour, 6 months ago.
Fine, that was 6 months ago. Let's talk about the here and the now, John F.
At that Leeds Irish Center with like loaded diapers in the.
That was we crawled through glass. Yeah, to play for you.
We siphoned the gasoline out of our truck.
That sounds like
an exciting. We were slammed by the Guardian for the fourth time.
What an exciting night out for
it
everyone!
Was fantastic.
But never mind that. Here now, how many dates are you doing back in the
one?
UK? Well, there you go.
Exclusive date.
I rest my case.
But we're doing every single radio show possible, starting right here.
Well, I'm pleased that we got you first.
Slowly cascading downward.
We've got you full of energy, full of brio.
Yes.
So they might be going to playing only in London this time around.
Well, we're playing in Barcelona as well at some crazy festival. We're
you really think
kids.
People listening in London and the UK here are going to get on a plane and go to Barcelona?
I think they're buying their ecstasy right now and they're getting on the bus.
You'll be checking out the architecture over there, of course.
Oh, yeah. Oh, it's going to be trippy. We're playing in the middle of the night. We're playing at 2 in the morning.
Wow.
In Barcelona.
Is that a good thing or is that a bad thing?
Well, considering how jet-lagged we are, I think it's just it won't perfect. Make any difference at all.
It's great to have you back here. As you know, I'm a fan, of course. I think everyone knows that. You have two new albums out, sort of new, sort of not new, to TMBG fans.
Yes.
Well, one is a package of some of our beloved songs. It's called A User's Guide to They Might Be Giants.
Available in truck stops everywhere.
You know, but this is good value for money. 29 tracks.
Well, it's the people at Rhino who really do the reissue stuff the best, I think. You know, we did a box set with them a couple of years back, and then we put this together. And what's interesting about this compilation, I don't know if you can see from the graph on the back, but it's all the songs are sequenced in order of length.
The lines represent the lengths of the songs.
Wow, that's a lot of thoughts going into that. So it starts with
or very little thought if you're just putting together by song. I mean, sequencing.
We didn't have to think any beyond that. Right? There wasn't any those two don't go together.
The opening song is 40 something.
47 seconds, and then it goes up to the longest one, which is 3:49. Not that long. You're not known for your long.
No.
Where's your Bohemian Rhapsody, exactly. guys? Where's your epic song?
I think that's it. 3:49.
It's our Bohemian spirit. It's our new wave spirit. You know.
Well, what
David Byrne said, "Say it once. Why say it again?" And we believe in David.
You're still carrying the torch.
Yes.
What was that track you did? I can't remember the name of it. My wife would kick me because she knows them all backwards. The one where you have a little burst of like, who's that?
Oh, yeah. Would you like us to perform it right now?
I would love it, but wait a second, because is that on here? Because that could be your Bohemian Rhapsody.
I think it is on there.
It's called Fingertips.
It's called Fingertips.
It's
all of like 3 minutes long, but it's got about 18 different songs in it.
Yeah, you see, now if you were to actually expand all of those songs, to lay a minute and a half each, which you could easily do.
We'd have a
then you've got a whole set, but you've got basically one long song, which we could then do a very flamboyant video.
Yes, mm-hmm. Yes. There's the possibilities are endless. But
do you guys ever spend any time talking about what you're going to wear on stage?
Yeah, sometimes we talk about...
What are you implying?
Well, you always look to me like you've just rolled out of bed, and that's not a bad look, but I long to see you one time come on stage in Elvis gear or in a jumpsuit. You guys in Lycra would be a treat.
For the ladies.
And some gentlemen.
We sometimes wear suits on stage, which looks really sharp, but
it still looks like we've just rolled out of bed.
I tell you, Lycra. Anyway.
I think we have kind of that like 8-year-old boy, in church kind of problem, which is, we just feel really itchy in that. I mean, we never really wore costumes.
John, I have. This probably won't surprise you.
You dress, but you dress. It's not fair coming from you because you dress immaculately.
Calm down.
And
calm
it's
down.
The radio.
Yeah, well, hang on.
It doesn't
people
matter.
People can't see
you're wearing
you.
A beautiful suit right now, and no one can see you.
You're both getting defensive here. There's no need.
I don't know.
Okay, here's the thing. I have in my possession any number of superhero costumes. Now you're gigging on Thursday.
Yes.
What do you think?
I think you should come out wearing a superhero costume.
I will if you will.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Come on. I will. I've got Spider-Man. I've got Mr. Incredible. I've got the jumpsuit from Kill Bill, formerly of Game of Death. You know, fellas. What are you thinking, John? You're thinking yes?
I'm having racing thoughts.
Your mind's saying no, but your heart's saying yes, isn't it, John?
Yes, yes.
Okay, well, let's do that.
We can, well...
John, what about it? Come on. Don't sit there and squirm. What about it? What a treat that would be.
We can neither confirm nor deny that that's going to happen.
All right, well, I shall apply some subtle pressure.
We'll have people get back to you on that one.
We're going to play another track now and give you a chance to sort of get the sounds right here. Yeah, what are we going to play, Andy? Anyway, that's by the by. They Might Be Giants with us. They're known to the initiated as TMBG. Many years ago, John L. was in a new wave band called The Mundanes.
That's true. Yes.
I have never heard any of The Mundanes material. Was any ever recorded?
We made a single, which was produced by us,
Back in the heady days of vinyl.
That's right.
They were a skinny tie band, I think.
Oh, yeah. So slightly like the Knack, perhaps.
Pre-Knack, but
it didn't sound like the Knack, but it looked a little like the Knack.
I bet you were slightly more intelligent than the Knack.
I don't know.
And what was the track?
Well, we had made a single that had there were short songs, so we had three. There was one side with two tracks, one side with one track. The A side was called. Do you remember? I can't.
I think it was called
"Make It the Same."
Make It the Same.
But you did a cover of that song by the
did a lot of exciting covers.
What was the one? What was the one by the group from '65? The Vogues.
We did 5 o'clock World. By
wow.
The Vogues.
Yeah. You see, I'd like to see a little part. Maybe you could carve a little hole in the middle of your TMBG set and just have a little Mundanes reunion.
That would be exciting.
Wouldn't that be great?
Yeah. Or at least do some Vogue songs. I mean, the Vogues are a great band. I imagine you play some Vogues.
I have never played the Vogues on this show.
Oh, they're very kind of, not of their time. They're a vocal group in the '60s when vocal music was basically.
So not psychedelic, not like the Seeds or something.
Right. No, the 5 o'clock World. What was their other big hit? They had one other big Magic Town. I don't know. They're
a
cool band.
We will see. Them out and try to play the Vogues next week on the show so people now know what we're talking about. TMBG are playing only the one gig in town this time, but being a working band, I'm sure you'll be back either by the end of this year or certainly next year, so the rest of you will get a chance to see him. I'm going to be down at the gig. I might have to arrive late on Thursday because I record my talk show Thursday, but the whole family are excited.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Well, we indoctrinated the kids early on into your music. When Betty, my eldest, was first born, we thought, what, we have to play her something quite special. What should we play? The first track we ever played for her virgin ears was Particle Man by TMBG. Yeah? Which is
sweet.
And I think had a nice message to it as well.
Baby's first song.
Yeah, Baby's first song. But now you have whole albums out designed for babies.
Yes, we do.
No did well for you, didn't it? It was quite a bit a popular selling.
It was very, very big.
It was a big shock to us.
And but it never really had a proper release in the UK. We actually sold a lot of imports, so we know that it was of interest here, but it never had a proper release here. So now it's finally out sort of in tandem with this.
Well, I have an email here from Jeff Watts emailed and said when we were standing for Terry on the breakfast show, we played a series of TMBG songs as a kid slot and his children loved it, especially the song about there is a house in the woods and in the house there is a, the one we're talking about.
Sure.
With the dog, with the mouse and the crisps and he gets angry.
Exactly.
And they didn't catch the title of the song and that song was called,
At the Top of the Tree.
House at the Top of the Tree. And that is on No, the album which is out now, coincidentally. Yes. So Jeff, you can finally realize that dream. Make it happen, Jeff. Make it happen for the children.
Would you like to hear a very adult song?
Hold on. Because I believe children are the future.
Are they?
What do you believe, John?
That's controversial.
Yeah.
I think there's some who would argue.
I went to see
facts aren't really in about children being the future. We need some more scientific study.
They may be the past.
New Republican administration we've got is a... different ideas about that.
I went to see Whitney Houston before she went a bit nuts. I went to see her years ago performing live in the round at Wembley Arena. I don't quite know why. And at the time, I was walking out with a young lady who was of Italian origins and very, very small indeed, under 5 foot, dangerously close to 4.5. And we sat right in the front row and Whitney came out. And before she sang, I believe, she said, this is for any children. Are there any children in the audience? And looked out and saw this small Italian woman and went, there's one there. And she stood up and said, you can... and got furious with Whitney, and there was a moment where I didn't know where my allegiance really lay.
Right, and that was Whitney, the beginning of Whitney's downward spiral.
Those were the days, though. All right, so what are we going to hear, fellas?
Well, we actually are doing a series of songs at this show called Venue Songs, and we basically, on tour last year, we were playing for a few months straight, and we decided that we were going to write an original song for every venue in which we performed, and... this next song we wrote for the Anaheim House of Blues, which is actually in the middle of Disneyland, but it's the House of Blues itself is entirely for adults. It's like just hard drinking, hard smoking,
hard party.
So it's a paradoxical venue, and the song kind of focuses on that.
Shall we count you in anyway, or are you ready to go?
I think we're ready to go.
Okay, take it away.
One, two, one, two, three.
night and watch Death Wish 3. Fall asleep with pizza crumbs on my clothes. So put away that hash pipe, pornography and the booze, 'cause tonight we're going to the Anaheim House of Blues. Don't do anything crazy, like defecate in your pants because you're lazy. No, put away that crack pipe, put some makeup on that bruise, 'cause tonight we're going to the Anaheim House of Blues. Oh, take me down to the Anaheim House of Blues. Oh, drag me by my hair to the Anaheim House of... Good night, Mrs. Hitler.
What about that? No, you see,
you don't get that kind of thing on radio much anymore.
But it used to be. It used to be you'd hear that kind of thing.
Remember
all
the good time music?
Well, but
of
used to be, because seeing Marty suddenly produce the horn as if from nowhere, that excited me. Because there's you seen the film The Little Shop of Horrors, the big budget version, and John Candy plays a crazy style radio DJ who has any number of sound effects, like horns, and I've often thought that would be the way to go. And today we have the chance. I feel we almost sampled that old style broadcasting.
You don't want to know what Marty's got back there.
Marty's quite the sort of like secretive gentleman, isn't he?
Yes.
Are you performing with a lot of people this time? Because it's just the two of you. So you've got a four band. That means what? Yeah, how many?
It's super loud. We've got two guitars, bass, drums, keyboards.
You don't need a lot of people to make a big noise, though, do you, these days?
As long as you have the large enough amplifier and the deaf sound man, I think you're all set.
That's the secret, isn't it? But you play around with sound quite a lot, don't you? I mean, you play a number of unusual instruments. The accordion is always welcome in my house.
Yes,
certainly.
Yes.
And you use it more often than many.
You know, the last time we were here, we brought a stylophone.
Oh, yeah.
And we played it. We used it in the show that week. And you told me that you had one which was broken.
Yes.
The day after that gig, mine broke. So I realized that they are not very roadworthy.
Or maybe I'm not to be allowed near them.
Maybe I'm not to be allowed near them.
Maybe no one. Maybe that's why they fell from grace. Because let's face it, they were a happening instrument.
It's such a beautiful thing, and it's so fragile. It's like life itself.
I think David Bowie has several that have been professionally restored.
Yes.
Yeah. He has a man, actually, who goes on tour. He has a stylophone tech who goes with him just to make sure that it's ready for use. Because he uses it in one of his songs.
It's Space Oddity, I think.
Are you fans of what we would consider to be more conventional music for this? Because your stuff is, there's always a kicking tune in there. But the lyrics are kind of like often layered.
Give us a name. Give us a song.
The
Beatles.
Old style rock and roll, like the Beatles, like the Rolling Stones, like James Brown, that kind of stuff.
Well, we're crazy old, for guys in a rock band. I mean, I think also, we grew up in the new wave moment where, Elvis Costello and people who understood the power of a short, powerful song.
Yeah.
And there's something progressive about that because you really have to have an idea to do a good song in that format. But it's also classic. Songwriting.
And some of your songs are, they don't have, I mean, often there's a double meaning or there's a humorous thing. Sometimes you do write stuff which seems much more from the heart.
Yeah, we have hearts.
Yeah, I know you have hearts. I wasn't
just barely.
But occasionally, and I wonder, are you more comfortable or less comfortable doing that kind of thing?
I think, I think we just want to have it be kind of wide open. I think we sort of treat the whole thing as an experiment.
Are there ever times when you think you've done too many of the silly songs?
This interview has suddenly gotten very serious.
I'm interested in your work, John, and you should respect that.
Right.
For once, I'm actually asking you questions that you know the answers to. I'm interested about whether or not, when you're playing a number of songs which are, let's say, sillier or lighter, like Hotel Detective, and then you play, say, Particle Man, then if you switch to something like New York City or Bangs Even, which is more about people in your life, does that feel strange? Do you have to ease the gear change?
I think that we, like John said, we just try and do something good, and we haven't really got a set definition of what it is. I mean, even after 20,000 years in the music industry.
You sort of shift it around. I mean, you think about it a little bit, but it's usually more about tempo than the emotional part of it.
Yeah.
Because there's certain keys that we're uncomfortable with,
actually. I watched recently, there was a documentary that came out about you guys.
Yeah, yeah.
And I watched it, and I was intrigued to see that there had been a show in America, which I suspect very few people actually watched, but it was a noble idea about modern science.
Yes.
And you were recruited to write specific songs, small tunelets, shall we call
very
them.
Very specific subjects,
What were the kind of subjects? Can you remember off the top of your
head? There was one about the particle physics or whatever.
There's one about string theory, which some of your listeners may have heard of.
I don't think anyone here actually understands string theory.
Well, we certainly understand it. But some people have heard of it. That was one song, and we wrote a song which I don't think that the producers of the show were very happy about this, but we wrote a song attacking string theory.
Oh.
I think they were hoping we'd explain it.
A radical position to adopt.
Yeah, instead we were saying,
Who cares?
This is wrong.
I won't ask you for the string theory song. I think we can't play that.
It was actually highly rocking.
Well, it might be a bit heavy for this time of the day. But I would ask you something else now. Could you do fingertips?
We can just barely squeak by.
Okay, we should introduce this. This is a real favorite in my house, so I hope you're listening at home, guys, because I know Harvey.
If you're driving, it might be a good time to pull the car over and just...
If my kids are listening, Harvey, Honey, and Betty, I'm going to dedicate this to you. Andy, would you like to dedicate this to anyone?
No, I'm just going to listen myself.
John, would you like to dedicate this to anyone who's listening? Either John?
All the people driving.
All the fingertips everywhere.
All the fingertips. Okay.
Marty, anyone you'd like to dedicate this to? Marty can't believe he's lucky. He's never normally spoken to. This is normally kept in a box.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. This is They Might Be Giants live for you on Radio 2. Fingertips.
Everything is catching on fire. Everything is catching on fire. Fingertips. 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 I hear the wind blow. I hear the wind blow. It seems to say, hello, hello. I'm the one who loves you so. Hey now everybody, now hey now everybody, hey now everybody now. Who's that standing at the window?
I found a new friend underneath my pillow.
Oh, come on, Rebecca, oh, come on, Rebecca, oh, come on, Rebecca, come on, in my car.
Aren't you the guy who hit me in the eye? Aren't you the guy who hit me in the eye?
Please pass the milk, please. Please pass the milk, please. Please pass the milk, please. Leave me alone, leave me alone.
Who's knocking on the wall?
All alone, all alone, all by myself.
What's that blue thing doing? I cannot understand you.
I don't understand you.
I don't understand the things you say. I can't understand a single word. I don't understand you.
I don't understand you.
I cannot understand you.
I don't understand you.
I don't understand you.
No understando.
No understando.
I don't understando.
I turn around, see the sound. Turn around and see the thing that made the sound.
Mysterious whisper, mysterious whisper, mysterious whisper, mysterious whisper. The day that came to play.
I'm having a heart attack.
Girl, you know it's true.
I'm having a heart attack.
H-E-A-R-T attack to you, girl.
I'm having a heart attack.
And if I die before we freak, remember,
I'm having
a, I will always love you.
I'm having a,
I will always love you.
Walk alone.
I think we must have made a lot of people very happy and probably confused a lot more. There's people thinking, what was that? That is They Might Be Giants' very own Bohemian Rhapsody, ladies and gentlemen. That's yes. Fingertips. I don't think that is on the user's guide.
It's not on the user's guide.
That's crazy. Wrong.
Denied.
That is wrong, but having said that, but these are more what we'd call tunes on here.
I realize we've just played two of the most alienating songs.
Yeah, I was thinking that as well. I was thinking, like, I'm not doing you any favors here, encouraging you.
Driving people away.
So now we're going to play a track that is on the album, and this will reassure them as to your good intentions as to tune smithery. This is Anna Eng, one of my favorite all-time They Might Be Giants tracks. See, they do write pop, you see. It's not just stuff which I like because it's crazy. They Might Be Giants are playing Thursday night. No is out right now. I urge you to get it for your kids. It's because you're stuck in a car with children. They want to listen to something. Normally, it's something you can't bear the sound of. You're like Ray Milland at the end of The Man with the X-Ray Eyes, but instead of trying to pull your eyeballs out, it's your ears you're aiming for. With No, you don't have to do that.
And you're going to have to hear it over and over again.
Yeah, and this one works. Apart from maybe violin. That one I sometimes skip through, I'll be honest with you.
You can press the little skip button.
Yeah, we skip occasionally. The kids like it, though. User's Guide to They Might Be Giants is also out right now. It's got 29 must-have They Might Be Giants classic tracks. They've had any number of hits over the years. They're going to play one more for you live. And this, of course, is, I think, one of your best-known songs, isn't it?
In the UK, it's probably the one.
Is it really?
I would say.
Okay, this is Birdhouse in Your Song.
I'm your only friend, I'm not your only friend, but I'm a little glowing friend, but really I'm not actually your friend, but I am. Luke and Harry and the Island by the Light Switch, who watches over you? Make a little birdhouse in your soul, not to put too fine a point on it. And I'm leaving out the whistles and bells, so the room must listen to me. Fill the bus diligently. My name is Luke and everyone not spelled L-I-T-E. My story's infinite, like the London Symphony. It doesn't rant. Luke and Harry and the Island by the Light Switch, who watches over you? Make a little birdhouse in your soul, not to put too fine a point on it. Say I'm the only me in your mind.
Mr. John Flansbury.
I'm your only friend, I'm not your only friend, but I'm a little glowing friend. But really, I'm not actually your friend, but I am. There's a picture opposite me of my primitive ancestry, which stood on rocky shores and kept the beaches shipwreck free. Though I respect that a lot, I'd be fired if that were my job. After killing, chasing off, and countless screaming argonauts, the burn of friendliness, like guardian angels, it's always near. Looking here in the by the light switch, who watches over you? Make a little birdhouse in your soul, not to put too fine a point on it. Say I'm the only bee in your body. Make a little birdhouse in your soul. And while you're at it, leave the nightlight on inside the birdhouse in your soul. Not to put too fine a point on it. Say I'm the only bee in your body. Make a little birdhouse in your soul.
If only for the children, let They Might Be Giants into your life. Thank you, fellas.